In this video, I have recorded several of my favorite Bible promises. An important principle of the Bible is found in Psalm 119:11. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. When we memorize God's promises, we are strengthened to walk in his ways. May these promises bless you as they have blessed me. 1 Timothy 6:6. But godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into the world, and we can take nothing out of it. But if we have food and clothing, we will be content with that. Those who want to get rich fall into temptation and a trap and into many foolish and harmful desires that plunge people into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is the root of all evil. Philippians 4:11. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. Proverbs 19:23. The fear of the Lord leads to life. Then one rests content, untouchable by trouble. Psalm 139:23. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxious thoughts, and see if there is any hurtful way in me, and lead me in the everlasting way. John 14:6. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Matthew 11:28. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Romans 5:8. But God commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. 2 Corinthians 6:14. Do not be yoked together with unbelievers. For what do righteousness and wickedness have in common? Or what fellowship can light have with darkness? What harmony is there between Christ and Belial? Or what does a believer have in common with an unbeliever? What agreement is there between the temple of God and idols? Genesis 3:15. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Luke 11:23. He that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not with me scattereth. Matthew 6:24. No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Romans 6:16. Don't you know that when you offer yourselves to someone as obedient slaves, you are slaves of the one you obey, whether you are slaves to sin, which leadeth to death, or to obedience, which leads to righteousness?